on the second row. Third row is the 89 of Matt Henderson. Wade Rooker, if he can catch up. Here we go, field coming out of turn number four. Green flag is in the air. We are racing. Summit Racing Equipment, he raced number one. Mark Lamont quickly jumps in the lead. Sean Flannery will move in the second. Now we got a battle for the third spot between the 16 seed of Josh Harris and also the 12 of Lucas Lee. First lap in the books. Mark Lamont, your leader. Sean Flannery in second. Josh Harris in third. And now back is the 12 of Lucas Lee, the 89 of Matt Henderson. The top four will transfer. The rest will go to a consolation race. Now we get a battle for the second spot as the 16 seed of Josh Harris moves to the inside of Sean Flannery, takes over second, and sets his sights on race leader Mark Lamont in the seven. Three laps in the books, five more to go. Mark Lamont, your leader. Josh Harris in second. Sean Flannery tags the outside wall midway down the back stretch. Does it slow him down? Sean Flannery hanging on to that third spot. The 12 of Lucas Lee holding on to that transfer spot. Matt Henderson in fifth is going to have to make up some ground if he's going to transfer into the feature from this heat race. Five laps down, three more to go. Now the 16 seed of Josh Harris, he slips up a little bit over at turn number two, and that allows Sean Flannery to catch up. Flannery will go to the inside as they come out of turn number four. Nothing doing. Mark Lamont, still your leader. Josh Harris in second. Sean Flannery right there in third. Again, the top four will transfer. Now they'll catch up to the lap car, the 00 Jeff Acar. White flag in the air. The all three get by Acar with no problem. Now we've got a battle for the lead. Josh Harris has moved up to the back bumper of race leader Mark Lamont. Don't count out Sean Flannery. Here they come out of turn number four. Checker flag is in the air. Mark Lamont, your winner. Josh Harris in second. Sean Flannery will come in third. And Lucas Lee will come in 12. And the top five will go across the scales. The top five, the 89 of Matt Henderson coming in fifth. Moving into the first transfer spot, the 12 of Lucas Lee. Coming in third, the 98 of Sean Flannery. Finishing second, Lucas Lee in the 12 car. And put your hands together for the winner of Summit Race Equipment Heat Race number one, the 7 of Mark Lamont. Again, Mark Lamont out of Crossville, Indiana, currently fifth in America Modified Series points in that Bandit race car powered by a Spec Racing engine. So Lamont will start on the pole of tonight's America Modified Series 30-lap feature. See, it's the 16 of Logan Hickey. Logan Hickey in a Shaw race car to his outside out of Walton, Kentucky in the 51 machine. It is Brandon Green. Started on the inside of the third row out of Dandridge, Tennessee. Longtime East Tennessee veteran. It's the 00 of Stanley Donahue to his outside. Another veteran, the 4 of Wayne James. Here we go. Green flag in the air. Fast shafts. Heat race number two. Here we go. Cameron Marler. And we may be calling this one back. Yep. And we will. Hickey, Brandon Green in the second row. East Tennessee veteran Stanley Donahue and Wayne James in the third row. And bringing up the rear, the zero of Terry James. Looking for a cleaner start this time by. Marler jumps in the lead as Logan Hickey and John Klippinger. They touched a little bit. Logan Hickey will move into the second spot. Going way down low in turn number three, the 51 of Brandon Green. First lap in the books, Cameron Marler, your leader. Logan Hickey in second. Brandon Green trying to go to the inside of the 16 JC of John Klippinger. Two laps in the book, Cameron Marler, your leader. Logan Hickey second, John Klippinger third. Battle's going on for that third spot. John Klippinger slides up just a little bit, and that'll allow Brandon Green to go to the inside. They'll go side by side into turn number three. Still side by side as they come out of four. Klippinger does hold on to the position. Brandon Green right there on his back bumper Up front, Cameron Brawler with about a 5-car length advantage over second place Logan Hickey. 5 laps in the books, 3 more to go. Cameron Brawler, your leader. Logan Hickey in second. John Klippinger holding on to third. Brandon Green in that fourth and final transfer spot. Six laps down, 2 more to go. Cameron Brawler on cruise control has extended that lead over second place Logan Hickey. White flag in the air for Cameron Brawler. 1 more lap to go. No change in the top 4. Coming out of turn number 4, checkered flag in the air for Winfield, Tennessee's Cameron Brawler. So that'll do it for Fast Shafts Heat Race number 2. Coming in fourth in the final transfer spot, the 51 of Brandon Green. Finishing third in the 16C is John Klippinger. Finishing second from right down the road in Morristown, Tennessee, is the white number 16 of Logan Hickey. And put your hands together for winner of the Fast Shafts Heat Race number 2. He'll start on the inside of the second row tonight's 30-lap feature out of Winfield, Tennessee, the 357 of Cameron Brawler. Cameron Brawler will also get a $75 gift certificate from Fast Shafts. That front row, Don Adams, David Mitchell in the second row, Robert Poole and Amos Bunch in the third row, and Brian Shaw and Blake Brown in the start on the fourth row. Again, the winner of this 8-lap heat race will start on the outside of the front row in tonight's 30-lap feature, looking for a good, clean start. Good start. They'll race down in turn number 1. Good race between Trent Young and Matt Cooper. Matt Cooper takes the lead going down the back stretch. Trent Young will try to move. Now he moves in the second. 1 lap in the book. Matt Cooper, your leader. Trent Young in second. Now we got a battle going on for third between Don Adams and the 90 and the 2 of David Mitchell. Got some cars battling all the way to the back, trying to make it up to that fourth and final transfer spot. As Brian Shaw is trying to get around the 50 of Amos Bunch. Up front, coming out of turn number 4 to complete lap number 4. We're halfway through. Trent Young's 2-year leader, followed closely by the 18 of Matt Cooper. Way on back, almost a full straightaway length advantage over the 90 of Don Adams. 5 laps in the books. Now Trent Young is going to try to find a way to get around the 18 of Matt Cooper. Excuse me, Matt Cooper, your leader so far. Six laps down, Matt Cooper, your leader. About 2 car lengths back to 10 of Trent Young. They're almost in a different zip code. White flag in the air for Matt Cooper. 1 more lap. Trent Young looks to the inside as they go into turn number 2. 1 more chance for Trent Young to try to take away the lead. And Matt Cooper will hold on to win Hypercoil Heat Race number 3. So that'll do it for Hypercoil Heat Race number 3, coming in fourth out of Robertson, Kentucky, the 2 of David Mitchell. Finishing third out of London, Kentucky, the 90 of Don Adams. Coming up in second, currently second in points, it's the 10 wide Trent Young. And put your hands together for a winner of Hypercoil Heat Race number 3 out of McKenzie, Tennessee, the 18 of Matt Cooper. So Matt Cooper will start on the outside of the front row of tonight's 30-lap feature, and he'll also get a certificate for 1 spring courtesy of Hypercoil Springs. Billy Palmer, that yellow number 36, 64 years old, and that is a 16-year-old race car, has won 2 feature races over at Tazewell Speedway this season. Up front, here we go, Taylor Cook, Nick Strope, We'll bring him to the green for Franklin Racing Equipment, heat race number 4. Good, clean start. Taylor go down to the bottom, to the outside. Nick Strub trying to take the lead as they go down the back straight. They touch just a little bit as Taylor Cook takes the lead coming out of turn number 4. First lap in the books, Taylor Cook your leader. Nick Strub in second. Michael Lee third, Jody Puck in that fourth and final transfer spot. Now we got problems with the race leaders. He goes into turn number 4. Taylor Cook slowed in turn number 4 and allowed Nick Strub to take the lead as they come down the front stretch. So don't know what happened to Taylor Cook, but as he went into turn number 3, he did slow and got a little bit high. He's gathered himself back up, and Nick Strub will take over the lead. Strub, your leader. Taylor Cook still having a little bit of problems out there. Michael Lee holding on to third. Jody Puckett in that fourth and final transfer spot. And Taylor Cook almost spins out in turn number 4. That will allow Michael Lee and Jody Puckett to slide by. Taylor Cook goes all the way from first to the fourth and final transfer spot. He's got to hold on to that spot if he wants to make it into tonight's feature race. 6 laps in the books. Nick Strub, your leader. Michael Lee in second. Jody Puckett third. And Taylor Cook holding on that fourth and final transfer spot. White flag in the air as Nick Strub moves past the lap car. Tyler James, all on his own, coming out of turn number 4, winning heat race number 4. It's Nick Strub. Michael Lee will come in second, Jody Puckett third, and Taylor Cook will hold on to that fourth and final transfer spot. He will move into tonight's feature. So coming in fourth in the final transfer spot, started on the pole but slipped back out of Charlotte, North Carolina. It's the 21 of Taylor Cook. Finishing third out of Melvin, Kentucky, it's the J3 of Jody Puckett. Finishing second, driver out of Paris, Tennessee, it's the 55 of Michael Lee. And winning Franklin Racing Equipment heat race number 4 out of Iron Station, North Carolina, in the Elite Chassis KS Engineering Power number 45. Put your hands together for Nick Strub. So Nick Strub will start on the outside of the second row tonight's feature, and he'll also pick up a $75 gift certificate courtesy of Franklin Racing Equipment. So that'll do it for Summit Racing Equipment American Modified Series Heat Races.
Things back over to Brady Cup. Where's Brady at?
So 8-lap Consi, top 2 will transfer. Matt Henderson in the lead. Stanley Donahue in second at final transfer spot. Wade Rooker in third. Wayne James in fourth. Again, they will take the top 2 out of this B main to go to tonight's feature. Way down, Matt Henderson in that Terror chassis house car. Commanding lead over to second place, final transfer spot, Stanley Donahue, but he's fixing to have his back bumper full, the 82 of Wade Rookard. Wade Rookard coming to us at a west burst second. Now he goes to the inside of Stanley Donahue. They make contact for just a moment. Donahue gets right back into it. He's going to chase him back down and try to take that second spot back. 6 laps in the books, 2 more to go. Wade Rooker in the show as of right now. He extends a little bit of a lead over Stanley Donahue, who's holding on to third. White flag in the air for Matt Henderson. Wade Rooker comfortably in second. Checker flag in the air for Loudoun, Tennessee's Matt Henderson. Wade Rooker will finish up in second. Little bit of right side body damage. So the top three will go across the scales. Matt Henderson in that Terror Chassis House car out of Loudoun, Tennessee. He will transfer to the feature. Wade Rooker in the 82 machine out of West Burnstack, Kentucky. Took that second and final transfer spot away from Stanley Donahue. And we'll let him go across the scales. If they weigh okay, they will go to tonight's 30-lap feature. So Stanley Donahue, Wayne James, Austin Atkins, and Jeff Acar, they will put him on the trailer. They'll try for better luck at Tazewell Speedway tomorrow night. We'll have a 40-lap feature racing for $3,000 to win. 8-lap B main. We'll take the top two. They will transfer into tonight's feature. Three wide going down the front stretch. Dust in the air. How can they see that? And their leader spins. Robert Poole spins, and we've got a yellow flag. See some damage to the right rear on the 25 of Robert Poole. So the 36 of Billy Palmer, the 50 of Amos Bunch, and the J4 of Tyler James, local guys trying to make it into tonight's big show. Billy Palmer, that yellow, remembered Scott Sexton. Got to see him about a year and a half before he passed away over at Tazewell Speedway. And great memories of the Superman, Scott Sexton. Here we go, back to green. See if we're cleaner listening now. Robert Poole slides his way into turn number one, and we've got a battle for that second spot. As the 312 of Greg Brown tries to hold back the 36 of Billy Palmer. Now the one car of Brian Shaw. He moves himself up to the mix, goes all the way down, doing some bottom feeding over in turn number two. He'll take the third spot away from Billy Palmer and set his sights for the 312 of Greg Brown to take over that second and final transfer spot. Two laps in the books. Robert Poole, your leader. Now Brian Shaw goes all the way down, tries to take that second spot away from Greg Brown. Brown shuts the door in the second turn. Now look at Brian Shaw all the way down, does a slide job, takes that second spot away from Greg Brown. So Brian Shaw started all the way back on the inside of the third row. Right now he is holding on to that second and final transfer spot. Halfway down, Robert Poole, your leader. Brian Shaw in second. Greg Brown in third. Five down, three to go. Robert Poole and Brian Shaw, they are in the big show as of right now. Two more to go now. Brian Shaw is gaining some ground on race leader Robert Poole, using that bottom groove to his advantage. White flag in the air. Robert Poole's got his back bumper full of Brian Shaw. And Brian Shaw, problems on the back stretch. And the yellow will come out. And they already took the checker flag, so tough break. What a tough break for the 1S of Brian Shaw as he had the second and final transfer spot wrapped up. And problems on the back stretch. So Greg Brown in the red number 312, he will come in second. He'll go to the big show. And Brandon Poole goes across the scales. If he weighs okay, he thumbs up, he will make it to the big show.